In this video, I'm going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet SSS, SAS, ASA, and AAS Congruence. So I'll quickly talk through each of the congruences side, side, side. If all three sides of one triangle are congruent to three corresponding sides of another triangle, then those triangles are congruent. For side, angle, side, if two sides and an included angle are congruent to a corresponding two sides and included angle, then those triangles are congruent. For angle, side, angle, if two angles and an included side are congruent to two angles and the included side of the other triangle, then those triangles are congruent. And finally, if two angles and a non-included side are congruent to the corresponding two angles and non-included side of another triangle, then those triangles are congruent. So in this video, we're going to state if the two triangles are congruent. If they are, we're going to state how we know. Looking at number one, we have a side congruent to another side, and we have an angle congruent to an angle, and this side is congruent to itself. So we have a side, and a non-included angle. However, we do not have an SSA congruence theorem, therefore this is not congruent. And number two, the triangles share the same side, so this side is congruent to itself. So you can see that we have an angle, an included side, and an angle congruent to a corresponding angle, included side, and angle. So number two, these triangles are congruent because of ASA. And number three, we have a shared side, so that side or segment is congruent to itself. And you can see that each side of a triangle is congruent to the corresponding sides of another triangle. Therefore, number three is congruent because of SSS, side, side, side. And number four, we have vertical angles, and we know that vertical angles are congruent. So this angle is congruent with this angle. We have one angle congruent to this angle, a side congruent to a side, and another angle congruent to another angle. We have angle, included side, angle congruent to a corresponding angle, included side, and angle. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent because of angle, side, angle, ASA. And number five, we're given that this side is congruent to this side, and this angle is congruent to this angle. However, that's only two pieces of information that's given, and not enough to say that these triangles are congruent. Therefore, in number five, they are not congruent. In number six, again, we have vertical angles, and we know that vertical angles are congruent. So this angle is congruent with this angle. And 90 degrees is equal in measure, so this 90 degrees is congruent to this angle of 90 degrees. An angle and an angle congruent to an angle and an angle of another triangle, and the included side is also congruent. So in number six, we have ASA congruency. And number seven, this side is congruent to this side, so we have a side and a side. This angle is congruent to this angle, so we have two angles that are congruent, and we have this side is congruent to this side. However, unfortunately, these two triangles are not congruent. That's because in this triangle, the included angle is the angle that's congruent, and in this triangle, the non-included angle is the angle that's congruent. Therefore, in number seven, the triangles are not congruent. In number eight, right away we can see that each side is congruent to a corresponding side. Therefore, the triangles in number eight are congruent because of side, side, side. In number nine, you can see that we have a vertical angle, and vertical angles are congruent. So this side with two tick marks is congruent to this side with two tick marks. This side with three tick marks is congruent to this side with three tick marks. And the included angle of each is congruent. Therefore, in number nine, we have SAS, side angle side congruence. And lastly in this video, we'll go over number 10. In number 10, the triangles share a same side. This segment is congruent to itself. Therefore, we have side congruent to a side, since it's congruent to itself, another side congruent to another side, and the last side congruent to the last side of the other triangle. So in number 10, the triangles are congruent because of SSS. Before you move on to the next video in this worksheet, remember to subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions, leave a comment below, or if you just want to let me know that you found this video helpful, comment and like.